Good evening, students. Today we are going to continue lesson number 1, rights, page number 11 and 13. In today's class, we are going to talk mainly about the questions that are there from page number 11 and 13. Let's come here. We see what can happen if human rights are ignored. How does that make people feel? So, if we see or if we find that the human rights are being ignored, so what can happen? So that is what we have to write, okay? And how does that that make people feel? Suppose any of us, okay, any of us are being denied of all the rights that we have. So what can we do and how do we feel about it? We have just come across, okay, all these things. That if we are wrongly accused, if we are not given the rights that we are supposed to get, then we can appeal. And just come to page number 7 where we have this related with this. It says in the beginning only, every person is entitled to certain rights simply by the fact that they are human beings. So just because that we are human being, and so and therefore what is happening, we are supposed to enjoy the rights. And if it is denied here, it says because they are rights, why are they rights? Because it says they are things you are allowed to be, to do or to have. These rights are there for your protections against the people who might want to harm or hurt you. They are also there to help us to get along with each other and live in peace. So these rights are there for our, it is said, for our betterment, to live in peace. And if these are violated, surely that person has to go through maybe so much difficulty. And sometimes it says, when we were reading about this one from page number 9, as we can see that it says page number point number 15, we are frightened. If we are frightened of being treated badly in our own country, we have we all have the right to migrate to another country for safety. So why do we need safety in order to live peacefully? We don't want that anybody who is outsiders to disturb us or to have anything with us. So according to the questions, it says, what can happen if human rights are ignored? That what can happen? The possible things that we can see, that peace, we may be disturbed. This peace is disturbed. We become both physically as well, physically maybe it's a torture, and as mentally, mentally also we are being tortured. So when these rights are ignored, that means we are not getting all these rights. So what is disturbed our peace? We are not able to read, we are not able to live in a place peacefully, and so there is both physical and mental torture. Just because of that, sometimes people might give up their life. There are so many cases when they are disturbed, when there is no peace, maybe in the family, maybe in the in the state or in the country, when we are not saved, there is no safety, then we take up other options that are there. Suppose we go to different country, maybe you are going to different country, or when we migrate, isn't it? So if there is also a problem, then what will be the options that is left? Maybe to give up one side. So if all these rights are disturbed, then what? We don't have peace, and ultimately we decide to go to migrate, maybe to go to some other country and to work. If that is also disturbed, if you are not getting, isn't it? So ultimately the person altogether gives it up. And we see just because of that, there are so many cases of suicide. insights and all that we experience. That is the first one. How does that make feel? Make people feel? Really, that makes a people very bad. Is a, of course, a very bad, but it is a disturbance. Okay, that causes. Okay, that causes problems to almost all the people who undergoes all these kind of difficulties in their life. So that was the first one. There is more. The second, it says, have you seen someone being treated unfairly or disrespectfully? Have you ever seen? Yes or no? Okay, write maybe in one or two sentences. Do you think everyone around the world should know the rights, know their rights? Do you think, or what do you, okay, what is your opinion, or what do you consider as, okay, whether the persons, okay, who are ignorant, who may not be knowing of their rights, okay, should they know about their rights or not? What is your view about it? What would happen if everyone knew their rights? If people know their rights, what would happen? If every one of us are aware of our rights, okay, what should we get, or what is our right? When we don't know, when we are ignorant of our rights, and the moment we come to know, what would be the difference? So when we know and when we do not know our rights, so what is the difference there? That is what we have to write maybe in one or two sentences. Now just come to page number 13. So all these questions are to be written in page number 13. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 questions altogether. So each of these questions are to be answered. So please write them. Let us see the first one. Name one country where human rights are violated. Which rights are those? So the first question, it says, name one country where human rights are violated. So we have to name a country where these rights that we have already seen in the previous classes. So which are those rights that are violated? And what are those rights? Okay, if we know. Let's see, altogether, okay, there are 167 countries where the human rights are, what to say, violated. The people do not get their rights. All these rights, okay, that we have already studied, those rights, okay, one of these rights are either the first one, second one, or this many rights that we have seen, okay, any of these rights are violated. So how many countries are all together? There are more than 167 countries, okay, where people do not get their human rights. So as a human being, okay, we have some rights, so those rights are not enjoyed by them. Namely, we can take Syria, then Somalia, then Turkmenistan, then we have Libya, Saudi Arabia. Okay, these are some names of the country, okay, where people, I've just told you quite two, three countries only, namely Syria, then Somalia, Turkmenistan, Libya, Cuba, then we have Saudi Arabia. So here are some of the places where people actually do not enjoy the rights. So what happened, okay, here, these places are where people, okay, suffer from, what to say, some of the most severe systematic abuses of human rights on the planet. So you see, what are those things? Okay, they suffer from what? Some of the most severe systematic abuses of human rights. Just okay, as we see, the political rights, the civil liberties, all these, okay, that they have, or the rights they have, okay, they don't actually get. So that was the first. Let us now move on to the second one. Name one country that worked hard to improve its human rights situations. Give one example. So name one country that we have, okay, like China, Netherlands, United States, then Sweden, Canada, Denmark, then we have Finland, Norway, Switzerland, New Zealand, United Kingdom, and Australia. So these are the names of some countries, okay, where people, where the countries have worked together, okay, they have started improving conditions or the rights of other people, so that okay, the rights okay, which are they are supposed to enjoy may reach to each and every. So we have these names. Third questions we have from here: name one person from any country who is known to work for human rights. So we have to name a person okay, who has okay given up his or her life for the sake of maybe for the others' betterment. They are working for the others, their human rights, for human rights, so that okay everybody enjoys this right. Namely, we have okay, that is Nadia Murad of Iraq. So we can say Nadia okay, Murad of Iraq. You see, this lady okay of Iraq, she also tried a lot so that okay, each and every people of Iraq or okay this or her nations we get this their rights. But we see okay, when we read about her, we will come to know that actually she was in the beginning just converted into Islam, and then okay, there were so much problem that she has to undergo both physically and mentally. And okay, after 2 to 3 years, she worked as a activist in the sense okay, human activist for working for the people. So this way okay, she has given up his life for the cause of many other people. This way we have got okay, Raif bin Muhammad Badawi of Saudi Arabia, then Alexa Salvador of Brazil, and Nancy Perch of Norway. So these are few examples of people okay, who have given up their life for the others. Okay, Raif bin. So one is there, Raif bin. Then the other one we have okay, Alexa Salvador. This way we see okay, quite many. Okay, Nancy also. Nancy is there. So dear students, okay, these are some of the questions okay that I have discussed with you. In case of any difficulties or the problems, you may ask me during the live class. Thank you so much.